Do you know of an easy way to move 5,000 tons of cargo from one place to another? You probably immediately think of a powerful tanker. But what if I told you that there is a land vehicle capable of lifting such weights? Today, you will learn about the largest and most powerful machines in US history. Believe me, these giants will truly amaze you. And at the end of the video, you'll see a machine capable of moving over 8,000 cars at once. Enjoy watching. Big Brutus. In our world, the amount of resources extracted increases every year. One of these resources is coal. It has been the backbone of the steel and energy industries. Or was it? Now humanity is moving toward more eco-friendly energy sources. But in the mid-20th century, this was not an option, and coal burning remained the foundation of the energy industry. To meet this demand, in 1962, the Bucyrus Erie Company developed Big Brutus, one of the largest mechanical coal excavators ever built. It was used for surface coal mining in Kansas and had impressive dimensions, 160 feet tall and 242 feet long. Thanks to its enormous bucket and powerful structure, it could move significant amounts of rock, ensuring efficient coal extraction. However, in 1974, the project was shut down due to the rapidly changing energy industry. Big Brutus was preserved and turned into a museum exhibit. 50 years later, it was added to the National Register of Historic Places in the U.S., marking it not only as an engineering achievement, but also as a cultural heritage, symbolizing America's mining history. A truly impressive exhibit. Big Muskie. Big Brutus was certainly the most efficient coal mining machine of its time, but the company that developed it didn't stop there. Just 7 years later, in 1969, Bucyrus Erie introduced Big Muskie, a giant excavator the length of a skyscraper, about 310 feet. This behemoth weighed over 12,000 tons. Big Muskie was used for surface coal mining in Ohio. Its operational efficiency was significantly higher compared to its predecessor. One would think nothing could go wrong. However, in 1991, this excavator was taken out of service due to high maintenance costs and the low economic feasibility of continuing operations in the changing coal and energy industries. Nevertheless, Big Muskie became a symbol of engineering prowess and power. It demonstrated the scale of projects that could be realized with modern technology and engineering solutions. Its bucket is now a museum exhibit at the Miners Memorial Park in Ohio, attracting tourists and researchers interested in the history of mining technology and industrial progress. Big Bertha. Here's another massive machine, though it doesn't mine coal, but creates. Big Bertha is the nickname given to one of the largest tunnel boring machines in the world, measuring 325 feet long and boasting more than 25,000 horsepower. Impressive, right? Big Bertha was designed specifically for the Alaskan Way Viaduct Replacement Tunnel Project in Seattle. This project was part of a program to replace the old elevated highway with a new underground tunnel to improve the city's transportation infrastructure. The machine began its work in 2013, but stopped after a few months due to overheating and breakdowns caused by soil entering the cutting mechanism. Over the next 2 years, the machine was lifted, repaired, and upgraded. In the end, it successfully completed its task. Despite serious technical difficulties, the project was successfully completed. The tunnel was finally dug. The project significantly improved Seattle's transportation infrastructure, reduced traffic congestion, and increased safety in the city. The successful completion of this work also advanced tunneling technologies and methods that will be useful in future projects worldwide. Marion 6360. It's time to talk about another coal giant. In 1965, the Marion Power Shovel Company did not want to lag behind its competitors and introduced Marion 6360, also known as the Captain. It outperformed its rivals in every way. It was over 450 feet long, about 220 feet tall, and had a bucket capacity of 180 cubic yards. Can you imagine that? Marion 6360 was designed to operate in the coal fields of Illinois. It was used for surface mining and quickly became one of the most powerful and efficient machines in the mining industry. Its scale and productivity allowed for a substantial increase in coal production. However, in 1991, Marion 6360 suffered a serious accident. A fire in the control cabin caused significant damage, rendering the machine unfit for further operation. Unfortunately, like the two previous excavators, restoring the machine was not feasible due to changing economic conditions. Stratolaunch. Okay, that's enough about excavators. Let me tell you about something more graceful. Stratolaunch is the largest airplane in the world, with a wingspan of 385 feet. Why would we need something like that? It was developed to launch rockets into the stratosphere, making it more economical and flexible to put satellites into orbit. It has a payload capacity of 250 tons and more than 150,000 horsepower. Stratolaunch features a twin fuselage design connected by a common wing, giving it a unique appearance. The central part of the wing is used to mount the carrier rocket. It really looks unusual. What do you think? Stratolaunch is truly a significant achievement in aviation and space technology. Previously, rocket launches were heavily dependent on weather conditions. Now, this giant plane's ability to launch rockets directly from altitude avoids weather delays and increases launch frequency. By the way, weather can negatively affect more than just rocket launches. For example, rain often causes traffic accidents. So, what should you do if you get into an accident in America? You don't have billions of dollars and a team of lawyers. Where do you go for help? How do you find a competent attorney? How do you get compensation if you don't have insurance? The company Car Accident America has helped clients receive $21 million in compensation. They will definitely answer all your questions. Link in the description. The first successful flight of Stratolaunch took place in 2019. The company is now working on new rocket launch systems with significant potential to change the entire industry. LeTourneau L-2350. But let's ground ourselves a bit and talk about the largest front-end loader in the world, the LeTourneau L-2350. This, strange as it may sound, baby works in the ray mine, where copper ore is extracted through open pit mining. This loader can move enormous volumes of material in a single cycle thanks to its large bucket and powerful engine, making it one of the most efficient wheel loaders in the world. Its height is comparable to a three-story building, and its 16-cylinder engine with over 2,300 horsepower burns 1,000 gallons of fuel every 24 hours. The width of the bucket is over 20 feet, and it can hold 75 tons of rock, or for instance, 50 miners at once. Interestingly, the loader was so large that it had to be assembled right at the job site. The LeTourneau L-2350 is an outstanding example of engineering prowess, representing a powerful and reliable tool for the mining industry. Its high productivity, durability, and operator comfort make it indispensable in harsh working conditions. By the way, we haven't talked about costs yet. If you want to imagine how much one of these machines might cost, consider this. Just one tire of the LeTourneau L-2350 is valued at $100,000. Caterpillar 797F. But our loader would be useless without the next giant, the Caterpillar 797F. This is one of the largest mining dump trucks in the world. It is designed to transport massive amounts of rock and minerals. Its length is comparable to the height of a five-story building, and with a 20-cylinder engine boasting over 4,000 horsepower, it can reach speeds of up to 43 miles per hour when fully loaded with 400 tons. Just think about it, 43 miles per hour with that weight. It's not a tank, but it certainly won't go around you. Moreover, the dump truck's cab is equipped with modern control systems, ergonomic seats, improved sound insulation, and air conditioning systems. In short, the operator is definitely comfortable. Not everyone's apartment has such amenities, let alone heavy machinery. The Caterpillar 797F is essentially the most load-carrying and heaviest vehicle in the world among those with a mechanical transmission. This monster is a remarkable example of engineering prowess, representing a powerful and reliable mining dump truck for working in tough conditions, an indispensable tool in the mining industry, USS Akron. Well, it's time to return to our flying friends. This time, let's talk about an airship. And, oh, not that kind, although that one is pretty cool too. Today, I want to tell you about the USS Akron, the largest airship aircraft carrier, built specifically for the US Navy in the early 1930s. It was part of a program to develop airships capable of performing various special missions. It was almost as long as two skyscrapers, with a total engine power of over 4,000 horsepower. Just imagine, this airship could carry 5 airplanes and required a crew of 80 people to operate. So, what could such a giant be used for? The USS Akron performed various tasks, reconnaissance, patrol, and basically testing the concept of an airship aircraft carrier. For 3 years, it participated in various maneuvers and demonstration flights. Then it got caught in a severe storm, and you could say, went down heroically. I'm sure the USS Akron was an ambitious project for its time. It represented the pinnacle of airship technology of that period. Despite its tragic end, it played an important role in aviation history and left a significant legacy in the development of airships and military innovation. At least, that's what they say. Personally, I've never seen an airship. Are they real or just a myth? Bucyrus RH400. Something is missing in this lineup. Probably another excavator. Did you miss them? Okay, I promise this is the last one. And this time it's not just huge, but the largest hydraulic excavator in the world. The Bucyrus RH400 is well known in certain circles for its power, performance, and impressive size. It can quickly and efficiently move massive volumes of material, making it ideal for large mining projects. Its two engines, with a combined power of over 4,500 horsepower, ensure high productivity and reliability in harsh working conditions. The excavator's cab is equipped with modern control systems, ergonomic seats, and excellent visibility. It may not be as comfortable as the Caterpillar 797F, which I mentioned earlier. Still, my idea of tractors and excavators is pretty limited, and this description paints a whole different picture in my mind. NASA Crawler Transporter. Now, let me tell you about a machine capable of carrying almost any other vehicle in this lineup. Intrigued? I present to you the NASA Crawler Transporter. This massive transporter is used to move heavy space apparatus and their components, from assembly buildings to launch pads. This machine is one of the largest and most powerful land vehicles in the world. No surprise there. Look at its size. It has a load capacity of over 8,000 tons and a total engine power of over 5,000 horsepower. These transporters played a key role in American space programs, from Apollo to current projects like the Space Launch System. This system was introduced in 1965 and performed excellently in its original form until 2012. It then underwent modernization, including structural reinforcement, improved control systems, and engine upgrades to increase payload capacity and reliability, making it even better and more efficient. The NASA Crawler Transporter is an outstanding engineering feat. It symbolizes the transition from early space programs to modern and future missions, including plans to explore the Moon and Mars. Its power, reliability, and ability to adapt to changing space program requirements make it a crucial element in the successes of the American space program. If you're still in the space race, just get yourself a couple of these and you'll be set. Well, that's all. Today, I told you about the largest machines in the USA, from giant mining dump trucks to flying fortresses. Each plays a vital role in construction, mining, and industry. By the way, let me know in the comments what you think about that transporter that moves rockets. Thanks for watching.